Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In the last several lectures, we have seen that factoring a quadratic expression into a pair of linear expressions is one of the primary methods used to solve quadratic equations. The trick is to find a pair of linear expressions that, when multiplied together, produce the quadratic expression. We also saw that it is easy to identify the factors of certain forms of quadratic expressions called special products. These special products include quadratic expressions that are the difference of squares and quadratic expressions that are perfect squares. However, not all quadratic expressions are special products. In this lecture, we will see that quadratic expressions can sometimes be factored by a trial and error process called factoring by inspection. So let's see how this process works. Let's start with a quadratic expression written in general form, ax squared plus bx plus c. First of all, there are some simple cases when trial and error is not needed in order to factor a quadratic. For example, if a quadratic expression has no constant term, factoring it into a pair of linear expressions is straightforward. Since every term will contain either x or x squared, one linear factor will be x, and the other linear factor will be the remaining expression. For example, to factor the quadratic expression 5x squared minus 2x, we can immediately see that x is one of the linear factors. The remaining factor is thus the linear expression 5x minus 2. Both of these factors are linear functions of x. So by setting these functions equal to 0, and solving for x, we can easily determine that the zeros of these linear functions are 0 and 2/5. Since the zero product property tells us that these are also the zeros of the quadratic function, the solution set of the quadratic equation 5x squared minus 2x equals 0 is 0 and 2/5. We can check these results by substituting these values back into the quadratic equation to see if they produce a true statement. Substituting the first solution, 0, for x, causes both terms on the left to become 0. Producing the true statement, 0 equals 0. So our first solution checks out. Likewise, when 2/5 is substituted for x, we get 2/5 squared in the first term, or 4/25, which when multiplied by 5, is 20/25, or 4/5. In the second term, we have 2 times 2/5, which is also 4/5. And since 4/5 minus 4/5 is 0, our second solution also checks out. So when a quadratic expression has no constant term, factoring by inspection is simple, since one linear factor will be x and the other linear factor will be the remaining expression. However, in the general case, when all three constants a, b, and c are non-zero, factoring by inspection usually requires some trial and error. We will assume that the quadratic expression we wish to factor has been put into the general form where a, b, and c are all integers. Now our goal is to find a pair of linear expressions that, when multiplied together, produce the quadratic. Let's represent these two linear expressions as px plus q and Rx plus S, where P and Q are the constants in the first linear expression, and R and S are the constants in the second linear expression. Even though all the constants in the quadratic expression are integers, the constants P, Q, R, and S in its factors may sometimes have values that are not integers. However, when factoring by inspection, we will only attempt to find values for P, Q, R, and S that are integers. This task is much simpler when the coefficient of x squared is 1. Since in that case, the values of P and R will also be 1, and we will only need to determine values for two constants, Q and S, given the values of B and C. As an example, let's say that the values of B and C are 5 and 6. So given this quadratic, is it possible to guess values for Q and S that will produce this quadratic expression? It will be helpful if we can narrow down the list of possible values. Let's start by multiplying these two binomials to see if this gives us more information about the values of Q and S. X times X is X squared. X times S is SX. Q times X is QX. And Q times S is QS. We can then group the two middle terms, SX plus QX, writing them as S plus Q times X, or Q plus S times X. Now the expression that we just produced is just another form of the quadratic expression X squared plus 5X plus 6. Therefore, the constant terms in both expressions must be equal. So Q times S must equal 6. And likewise, the coefficients of X in both expressions must be equal. So Q plus S must equal 5. So to find the values of Q and S which satisfy these two conditions, let's make a table of the different possibilities. We know that the product of Q and S must be 6. So we will start by listing all the possible integer values of Q and S whose product is 6. 1 times 6 is 6. Also, 2 times 3, 3 times 2, and 6 times 1. We could also repeat the same four pairs of numbers where both numbers are negative. However, this is not necessary since we know that their sum must be positive. Now we have narrowed down the possibilities to four pairs of integers. But we also know that the sum of Q and S must be 5. The only possible values for Q and S in our table whose sum is 5 are 2 and 3 and 3 and 2. So the factors of this quadratic expression are x plus 2 and x plus 3, or x plus 3 and x plus 2. However, since the x coefficients in both factors are the same, it doesn't matter whether q is 2 and s is 3, or q is 3 and s is 2. Either way, we get the same two factors. This will be true for any quadratic with an x squared coefficient of 1, since the x coefficients of its linear factors will also be 1. Therefore, when factoring a quadratic with an x squared coefficient of 1, it is never necessary to include values for Q and S in our table with their orders swapped. So So this quadratic expression has the factors x plus 2 and x plus 3. Now to find the zeros of the quadratic function x squared plus 5x plus 6, we set the two linear functions that are its factors equal to 0 to find their zeros. Solving the resulting linear equations, we see that the zeros of the linear functions are negative 2 and negative 3. Since the zero product property tells us that these are also the zeros of the quadratic function, the solution set of the quadratic equation x squared plus 5x plus 6 equals 0 is negative 2 and negative 3. To check our results, let's substitute these values back into the quadratic equation and see if they produce a true statement. Substituting the first solution, negative 2 for x, we get negative 2 squared in the first term, or 4, and 5 times negative 2 in the second term, which is negative 10. Since 4 minus 10 plus 6 is 0, our first solution checks out. Likewise, substituting negative 3 for x, gives us negative 3 squared in the first term, which is 9, and 5 times negative 3 in the second term is negative 15. Since 9 minus 15 plus 6 is 0, our second solution also checks out. So when factoring this quadratic expression, we were able to find values for Q and S, whose product is equal to the quadratic's constant 6, and whose sum is equal to the quadratic's x coefficient 5. Now let's try one more example, factoring the quadratic expression x squared plus 10x minus 24. Once again, we must find values for Q and S whose product is equal to the quadratic's constant, which in this example is negative 24, and whose sum is equal to the quadratic's x coefficient, 10. Once again, we start by listing all the integer values of Q and S whose product is negative 24. As we saw in the previous example, it is not necessary to repeat these same pairs of values for Q and S swapped. Since swapping these values ends up producing the same two linear factors. Now we must determine if the sum of any of these number pairs is 10. Since the only pair of values for Q and S whose product is negative 24 and whose sum is 10 is negative 2 and 12, the factors of this quadratic are x minus 2 and x plus 12. Now that we have factored this quadratic expression, we can find the zeros of the quadratic function x squared plus 10x minus 24 by setting the two linear functions that are its factors equal to 0 to find their zeros. Solving the resulting linear equations, we see that the zeros of this quadratic function are 2 and negative 12. Therefore, the solution set of the quadratic equation x squared plus 10x minus 24 equals 0 is 2 and negative 12. These results can be checked as we did before by substituting each solution back into the quadratic equation. Sometimes you may find that factoring a quadratic by inspection is not possible, even though the quadratic function has real zeros. Take, for example, the quadratic function x squared plus 9x plus 12. Graphing this function, we see that the function's graph intersects the x-axis at two points and thus has two zeros. So we know that this quadratic can be factored. But let's try to factor this quadratic using the inspection method and see what happens. Once again, since the x squared coefficient is 1, we can factor this quadratic into two linear functions, x plus q and x plus s. Now we find values for q and s whose product is equal to the quadratic's constant, 12, and whose sum is equal to the quadratic's x coefficient, 9. We then list all the integer values of q and s whose product is 12. Remembering that it is not necessary to repeat the same pairs of values for q and s swapped. Now we look for a pair of values for q and s whose sum is 9. But unfortunately, none of these pairs of integers add up to 9. The reason we were unsuccessful in finding values for q and s was because the values of q and s were not integers. In fact, the values of q and s were not even rational numbers. In this particular example, the constants q and s have values of 9 plus the square root of 33 over 2 and 9 minus the square root of 33 over 2. Likewise, the zeros of this quadratic function are negative 9 plus or minus the square root of 33 over 2. This example illustrates that factoring by inspection will not be possible for some quadratics. In these cases, we must resort to more powerful methods of factoring, such as completing the square or by using the quadratic formula, both of which we will examine in upcoming lectures. So far, we have used factoring by inspection only for quadratics whose x squared coefficient is 1. Since, as we showed, any integer values for p and r must also be 1. And we only need to determine values for q and s, given the values of b and c. However, when the coefficient of x squared is not 1, factoring by inspection can become more difficult, since we must not only determine the values of q and s, but also values for the constants p and r, given the values for three different constants a, b, and c. However, there are cases where factoring quadratics like this may still be practical. In the next lecture, we will examine a few of these cases.